Characteristics of Godly Wisdom. New. For your gift of any amount. How do we know if we are following biblical wisdom? In chapter 3 of his epistle, James sets the standard with 8 qualities of godly wisdom. First, godly wisdom is pure. False wisdom is characterized by bitter envy and selfish ambition. Godly wisdom is characterized by purity of motive. Second, it is peace-loving. Selfish ambition can start a war, but God's wisdom can bring truth and clarity where there is chaos. Godly wisdom is the kind of wisdom that comes from the very heart of God. Third, it is considerate. You have strength and power, but you have them under control so that when you have the opportunity to hurt somebody, you won't do it. Fourth, it is submissive. Being submissive means being willing to listen and willing to learn. To be submissive is to be humble and teachable, not a doormat to be walked over, but meek, so that your strength is guided and submitted to God, making you gentle and kind. Fifth, it is full of mercy. The word used here actually has a double meaning, forgiving those who wrong us and then being willing in our hearts to help them. Sixth, it is full of good fruit. You cannot manufacture the fruit of the Spirit. True spiritual maturity happens from the inside out for those who are indwelt by the Spirit of God and are seeking His wisdom moment by moment. Seventh, it is impartial. Those who live by worldly wisdom cannot be impartial because they are always trying to please someone, but those who live by God's wisdom are consistent, single-minded, and authentic. Eighth, it's sincere. A sincere person is genuine, without hypocrisy, and wears no mask. Godly wisdom is the kind of wisdom that comes from the very heart of God, who is all-wise. As you read and pray through the Word of God continually, you will find that your life is producing purity, peace, gentleness, willingness, mercy, good fruit, impartiality, and sincerity, and that's how you'll know the Word of God is taking root. Prayer. Lord, thank you for answering my prayers for wisdom by giving it to me generously. As I spend time studying your word and listening to your voice, I know these things will begin to take root in me. Help me to prioritize that time with you. I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
When you stop dealing with someone and your life starts to get better, don't go back. An ex, a friend, cousin, sister, doesn't matter who. Leave that evil spirit right where it is. Their only goal is to tear you back down. Open up your eyes. God is trying to level you up.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and He will surely see it through to the end. He says He makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to His purpose. You did not find God, contrary to the way it explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if He finds you, He is big enough, strong enough, and able enough to secure you and to keep you. You've got to believe that. In the book of Matthew, Matthew chapter 6 verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, "You will seek me," and what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued, and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Mr. Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it will be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or a zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakala zizohole. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rad. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this the same thing that God says? Come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like, dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sisley Rato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me, because there's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds.
Pick me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural.
Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watch and they all adore.